are you doing? I know, they're freezing. It's freezing out here. It's so weird. This X-Men franchise and the fans that follow it are so fanatical. How difficult is it to figure out what the next step is?
It's really difficult. It's difficult because we want to do it right for the fans. I follow the internet. You know, I read all the sites. Oh, you bet I do. We're making this for the public, but we have to please the fans. So, you know, we want to make sure we get it right. We want to make sure that they allow us to have our dramatic liberties so we can tell a good story and make it exciting, you know.
And you still have to tell the people who don't know anything about X-Men other than what they've seen on the screen the story. That's a very difficult thing to do. How do you determine how you're doing that?
Well, this one is a little bit different because we start off with him young. So we just start off telling a story, and all the characters are introduced. And whether you've seen the other X-Men or not, it really doesn't matter. This is a standalone story. It really is.
Is that how you're going to go with all the future X-Men spin-offs?
I think it's better that way. You know, I think they need to stand alone in their characters. We're mindful of where they're going to end up. I mean, we're mindful that, for example, General Stryker, you can't kill General Stryker because we know he's going to show up in X-Men 2.
Exactly.
So that's our job. You just come and watch the movie and we'll make it work.
Well, do you know which one is coming next?
No.
There's like two or three, or?
Well, hopefully there's a bunch of them. I don't know. We're in internal discussions now, and I'm hopeful that we'll develop a whole bunch of them.
Is there one that's like close to your heart that you would like to see next?
The next Wolverine, there's a story that takes place in Japan with a Japanese woman, two Japanese women actually, and the Silver Samurai. And it's really cool. I'd love to do that.